Today, as New York plans a tax on taxi fares, Gotham recalls the day when cabbies went on strike for a share of 1934's meter tax, and for good measure, demanded union recognition. The industry was at a standstill as the dispute raged to a turbulent climax. History, New York hopes, will not repeat itself. Today, the NRA had not yet been held unconstitutional. 4,000 representatives of industry heard President Roosevelt in Constitution Hall tell the story of the Blue Eagles' progress and call for more jobs and higher wages for American labor. Sharing the headlines quite often with FDR was Mrs. Roosevelt, here returning via Caribbean clipper from an 11-day survey of Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands. On this occasion, she was hurrying back to the Capitol to join the President for their 29th anniversary. A flying saucer, 25 years ago today, able to float down almost vertically thanks to its unique parasol wing. Simple, safe, and efficient, but somehow it never made the grade. Bela Lugosi and Boris Karloff, then and now the delight of countless horror movie fans, presided over a cat show. A black cat show, what else? Alley fighters and back fence tenors all. And the champ, well, he was ready for an immediate title defense. Today, with the stock market booming, it's possible to recall without wincing the time when Chicago's Union League Club decorated the dining room with $1,000-a-yard securities. The members were laughing, too, until the eye recognized a personal flyer that flopped in the big crash. It was the $1 million dining room, but to the insiders, this was the wailing wall.